My name is Florian. I'm application engineer for Atlantic Europe. And in this series, we want to show you how easy it is to set up and operate SUSIAccess. First part, we want to show you how to install SUSIAccess. I prepared some setup. We have one server, Windows Server 2003, and we have one client with Windows XP embedded. First, we will start to install the server. You can download the ISO file, which contains everything you need, the installation programs and also user manual. I printed out the user manual, what I have to do next step. The rest of the ISO file I burned on this USB stick, so just be careful, it's a bootable ISO file. So I have everything here and will put it now into the server. We have, by default, three folders inside of the ISO file. One is the documentation folder, which includes the latest user manual. One is the ESOS, we will need this later for setting up the client. And one is called just SUSI. So we are going now inside the SUSI folder and inside the server folder. So we have prepared a Microsoft Windows Server 2003. We have the TCP/IP enabled and we have enough disk space. Installation process. Start with the SQL Server 2005. We're going inside the SQL Server folder and just double click on the SQL Server Express. So that will take a moment. The SQL Server program we have provided for you has already some auto-configuration, so it will go through the process automatically and just request a few clicks from your side. After we installed the SQL Server, we are also going to install the management engine for the SQL Server by just double-clicking. We accept the license agreement, going to next. Name and company, we are just leaving the defaults, next. Management Studio Express is what we want, next. And install. We are going on finished. After installing the SQL Server and the SQL Server Management Express Studio, we have to reboot our PC to make sure all services running properly under our server. Okay, after we restarted our server, we are going now to configure and administrate some mandatory things for our SQL server. If you're going to start, we have the server configuration manager here, the user manual highlighted. So we have to set up the internet connection. So we're going to SQL, choosing TCP/IP, choosing IP addresses, active yes, enabled yes, IP address, still the server address, active port no, and TCP/IP port 1433. It's the same for IP all. So it's important that you have your main IP interface and the IP all it together. And apply. Okay. Now we have to restart the SQL Server Manager process. We are going to start administrative tools, services. We are choosing SQL. I'm going to restart. Instead of restarting, you also could only reboot your completely system. That would do the same and you would not have to look up for the services in particular one. Okay, so we are going now again to our USB stick to SUSI Server, and we are executing SUSIAccess server_setup.msi. Welcome to the Advantech SUSIaccess server setup wizard. Next. We have to agree the license agreement. Next. The SUSIaccess server listening port is 2002. We just keep it. Next. Now we are entering the database server IP address. It is the same like the system we are running right now. So we keep it like the same IP from the system. The database administrator login ID SSA. That was automatically configured with our SQL server. And the database administrator login is Advantech. He's asking us if we want to create the database now. Yes, we want. And then we are clicking next to install. Everything went okay, so we are just clicking on close. Well, in fact, we have now already installed our SUSIaccess server. What we are doing now, we are installing also an FTP server on our server, so we can backup the images from our clients to the FTP server. We have two ways. We can backup the images to the client's hard disk itself or to an FTP server. Here we are using the FTP server. In the package you can download from our homepage, there is also the open source software FileZilla server inside. You're just going to start it by double click. We agree to the license terms. We're just going to next. Don't change anything. Next. Keep everything like it is. Next. Next. Install. He's now asking how to connect to the FTP server. It's the server we are running on it. We are just clicking OK. And the FileZilla FTP server is started. Now we are creating a user. We are going to User. And we are going to Add. I call the user ESOS. And I recommend you to write this down. Okay. The user needs some shared folders. So we are going to add a folder. And I am here just choosing my local disk and program files. Of course, you could also take any other folder, or you can create an own folder where you put it in. That's not really a problem. Just click on OK. Make sure you can read files, write files, delete files and append, and also the directories itself, create and delete. And then we are going on OK. We have to change the timeout settings for the server. So we are going to edit settings. We are listening to the port 21, that's OK. We don't care about the numbers, but the connection timeout, we will set it to 1200 seconds. And to 6000 settings. And also the logout time we will increase. Okay, so that's it. If you are using a firewall, you have now to create some exceptions to make it more easier. I switched off the firewall so I don't get any conflicts with the firewall for testing. If you use it in a production area, you should activate the firewall. But how to activate it is very clear in the user manual, so I recommend you to start study the user manual. For the first part, we are done and we are coming now to install SUSIaccess console.